Are you ready to roll?
He's turned it off. I think he pressed the wrong one before.
It's already rolled anyway. Natural.
Yeah.
Happy Korean British boxers. We are here with Stacey Copeland, Commonwealth champion Stacey Copeland, after a trip to Africa, to Zimbabwe. Yeah. I mean, firstly, we haven't caught up since the actual fight and the trip. And what a trip and what an idea.
It was amazing. It's a fantastic opportunity. I mean, there's also just Mickey Ellison and Mark Leach went as well. And then Sam from London, but from our area, it was three of us. So we knew all the coaches as well, because like Nigel Travis was with us, Alex Matvienko, and obviously my coach, Blaine Eunice. So it was like even better, because they were just top coaches and top people to have with us. So it made the trip even better. So yeah, just an amazing opportunity.
And a good fight, a good competitive fight.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously your quality and your conditioning paid to, you know, in the later rounds. But what are your experiences of actually the fight itself?
Yeah, she was really tough. Like she hit hard, but she was very robust as well as an opponent, and it's exactly what we wanted, really. And we had to change our tactics quite a bit. Usually I'm a go forward fighter and I love to mix it, and that's just what comes natural to me. But for this one we had to box on the back foot. We had to mix it enough to like not let the judges say, you know, you've been too negative. So we had to go in every now and then and mix it up and try and stay safe, but ultimately box on the back foot, which is different for me, but it was good because it shows that you can, when you need to, adapt to the opponent to get the win.
And it felt like a buzzing sort of event. I mean, I know you guys were in the school doing training with them, and you're out and about in the community, and it sort of brought a nice feel with it as well, like a nice global feel.
Definitely.
To the event.
I mean, the last Brit to box over there was Ken Buchanan, yeah, in 1981. It's been 36 years, so it was great to be able to bring, you know, the Commonwealth title and British boxers back to Zimbabwe. So that was great, and the support over there was amazing. Like 118 million people watched it over in Africa, and we had the live stream in, which was great, with VIP boxing. So it was really good that everyone at home could. They kind of followed the journey throughout the week, I think, and we had so many people watching it who don't usually watch boxing, but you know, it caught on, and it was just great if you can bring a bit of positivity to people as well. That's the beauty of sport, isn't it? So that was even better.
You've been obviously itching to get in the mix for title fights, so you're the Commonwealth champion. There wasn't a belt presented to you on the night, though. There was a printout of the belt.
That was ours, actually, because we'd had it stuck up in the gym the whole time training, you know, for me to like keep focused on and keep pushing myself all the time. So yeah, it was deeply disappointing not to have the belt. It's a bit you dream about from being a kid, but it is what it is. Can't take away from all the positives, and there's going to be, it should be in a few weeks now. We've borrowed one off Craig Watson for now, so thank you, Craig. But they're making a women's one now, which I'll be the first recipient, and then all women thereafter will receive that. So you know, it's been worth that. But yeah, massively positive experience, and nothing will take away from that. It just would have been nice to have that moment for me and Blaine to have the belt, but it'll happen again in future when I win other titles. So
now, obviously, back on home soil now. You know, you've got the title. You also want to push on. You've mentioned in the past that you want to sort of fast track your way through these tough fights.
Yeah.
You know, what are you setting your sights on next as a team? What would you like to see happen?
Well, we were hoping to box in October on Steve Wood's show at Oldham, but my hand, I picked up an injury in Zimbabwe, and that's not going to allow me to be able to fight now, unfortunately. So I think we're probably now looking at February for the next defence of the title. That's going to be at the Liverpool Echo Arena.
Yeah.
It's the next UKV Africa show. And I suppose before that we could do, you know, like what you would call a tick over fight, really, maybe a six rounder, but just with the problem that I had with the hand, I don't think it's worth the risk. So everything's totally focused on that now, getting ready for February to defend the title, and it'll be brilliant to do it here. And
yeah, what show is that going to be on? Is that a VIP show? Or
no, it's Calicoda,
the right, African Calicoda show. Yeah.
So that'll be great, because there'll be other British fighters against the other African fighters again, and which is nice being part of the team and that, but also it's great for everyone here who's supported us all the way through to get to watch it here and get behind us. It'll hopefully be a massive positive for them as well. So it's going to be a while to wait, but sometimes you just have to keep that focus and patience, you know, for those big nights. That's what we all live for, so that's what I'm going to stay focused on now.
Well, listen, massive congratulations.
Thank
to you.
You.
And we're always looking forward to the next chapter.
Yeah.
And we're looking forward to seeing you down the line in some massive fights.
No, thanks for your support, and to everybody else as well. It's much appreciated, the support while we're over there for all the fighters. It was great, and, you know, so thank you very much.
Cheers, Stacey.
Thank
appreciate
you.
Appreciate your time. You know the score. Ha ha.